I'm Dr. Colin Campbell, a senior research scientist here at Meter Group, and today we're going to talk about the question of, can water potential put more money in my pocket? For the last several years, we've been working with a grower down in southern Idaho who's growing potatoes, and we introduced him to the concept of water potential a couple of years back, and he's been working with water potential trying to improve his yields. So here's a graph from his farm, and what we told him was that you need to keep your soil water potential in the range of that green bar that stretches across the screen. And so here we have several fields that he focused it on, and we can see how well he did keeping his soil water potential within that bar. When it dropped below it, it meant that his plants were uncomfortable and he needed to add water. So he was scheduling irrigation based on these data. Now, he's been doing it for a couple of years now, and I've been really interested to take a peek at the data to see if it was actually helping him. So we see what he did. Now, what was the result? So the first thing that we think about are pumping costs. Now, it ends up he plays quite a bit of money in pumping costs. And we see from 2018, which was before he started using the sensors, to 2020, he was able to reduce his pumping costs quite a bit. Now, when I see data like this, I start to wonder, well, is it because there were other factors that were kind of helping to not have to run the pump so much, not have to use water so much? Maybe it was an unusually cool year. Well, we went and compared the total reference evapotranspiration for all 4 years that we took measurements out in these fields. And what we found was that for all years except 2019, the reference evapotranspiration was pretty similar, meaning the requirement of water for that crop was going to be pretty similar. Now, in 2019, it was a kind of cool and dry year, and there was a little bit of difference there. So how did using soil water potential affect his yield? Did trying to reduce water and trying to make sure to use just enough, did it drop his yield? Interestingly, as we look from 2017 to 2020, we can see that 2020 was actually his highest yielding year. And from feedback from him, he also indicated that the quality of the potatoes that he was growing and the incidence of disease were both improved. Now, what about the cost of potatoes? So we're talking here over the 3 years. How much water does it cost to produce 100 pounds of potatoes in any given year? And from 2017, where it cost about 33 cents in water to produce a 100-pound bag of potatoes, he reduced that in 2019 to 32 cents. But in 2020, which was a pretty typical year, and when he really got good at using soil water potential, we dropped down to about 23 cents per hundredweight of potatoes. So this translates into some pretty staggering numbers. So in 2020, he reduced his water use by 38%, and the cost of water for 100 pounds of potatoes. But he also increased his savings by $13,000 and improved his yield by 8%. So I think the jury's still out on some of this, but what you should take home here is that there is a strong opportunity to use water potential to increase your water use and increase your quality and your peace of mind as you farm.